Hey all, my name is Brian. After many years of building with Angular, I'm here to help you level up your skills and build better apps. Ever wondered how Angular components actually talk to each other? Maybe you've been juggling inputs and outputs, or maybe you've heard whispers about this mysterious new model input. Well, in this video, we're going to break it all down. We'll start with a mostly blank component and add real-time communication between a parent and child, first with inputs and outputs, then with the newer model input approach. Let's get into it. Here's the super simple Angular app that we'll be working with. It's just a component that will eventually let us type in a username and reflect that value in the parent component. Let's start by looking at the existing code for this component. Right now, it's just a plain shell component. No inputs, no outputs, no internal state. Just an empty class, ready to go. Now, let's switch and look at the root app component where this username field component is included. This component doesn't have any signals or bindings yet. We've got the username field component in place, but there's nothing being passed into it or coming out of it yet. So, let's wire up a basic communication flow, starting with component inputs and outputs. Inputs allow data to flow into a child component from a parent, and outputs flow data from the child component back up to the parent component. For this example, we'll be using the input and output functions from Angular. These are the new functional equivalents of the classic decorators. First, let's define a username property. This property will be an input signal with a default value of an empty string. This will allow the parent to pass a value down into this component. Next, let's create another property named username change. This property will be an output, and it will emit a string value. This component will use this output to send updates back to the parent. Next, we need to add a function to handle input events from our text box. This function will be called when the value entered into the text box changes. Let's call it onInput. This function will take in an event. We'll use this event to get the current value of the text box. Once we have the value, we emit it to the parent with the output by simply passing it to the emit method. Okay, I think that's everything we need here. Let's switch to the template. Now we'll bind that logic to our input element. Let's start by using property binding to bind the username input to the value property on our input element. This sets the text box input's value to whatever the parent passes in via the username input. Next, we'll use the input event to call our onInput function. So now, whenever the user types, we'll emit the value back to the parent. Okay, that should be everything we need to add to this component. So let's switch to the root component. Here, let's define a signal in the parent to hold the username. I'll call it username, and I'll set the initial value to Brian. Now, we'll bind the signal to the child component's username input. This means the initial value we'll see in the input should now be Brian. And now, we can use our new custom username change event to update the value of this username signal. And just to make all of this more clear, in the example, let's show the current value here in the parent component below the username field component. All right, let's save and try this all out. Nice. The initial value Brian shows up in both the parent and child components. Now, if I type something else, look at that. The child sends the new value back to the parent and both stay in sync. Pretty cool, right? These two components are now communicating back and forth with each other and updating values as needed. But what if I told you all of this could be further simplified and written more elegantly? The input and output concept worked great. And if we were only using one or the other, I'd probably leave it as is. But we can clean it up using Angular's newer model input. This allows us to leverage two-way binding with less code overall. First, let's switch back to the username field component. Then I'll remove the output. We won't need it anymore. Next, I'll change the input over to a model input instead. This special type of input gives us a signal that allows us to propagate values back to the parent component, eliminating the need for a separate input and output. Okay, now that we're working with a signal, we need to set the value in our onInput function. Instead of emitting, we just update the signal directly. Okay, that's all we need to do here. Let's switch back over to the root component. The first thing I'm going to do is remove the username change event binding since the child doesn't emit this event anymore. Now we use Angular's built-in two-way binding syntax, often referred to as banana in a box, because of the parentheses inside of the square brackets. This connects the parent signal directly to the child's model input. Updates will now flow both ways automatically, from the parent to the child and from the child to the parent. Okay, let's save and see it in action. Nice. It starts with Brian in both the parent and the child. If I update the value, yep, still in sync. But now the code is simplified and still just as powerful. So there you have it. We started with the traditional input and output setup for component communication, then refactored it into something leaner and cleaner using the new model input. With just a few small changes, we made our code easier to follow and let Angular do more of the heavy lifting for us. If this video helped with the way you think about component communication, go ahead and give it a thumbs up. It really helps the channel. Got questions? Ideas? Or maybe you're already using model inputs in your projects. Drop a comment below. I'd love to hear how you're using it. And if you want more practical Angular tips like this, don't forget to subscribe. I've got more videos on the way to help you level up your skills and build better apps. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.